Hello, everyone. This is Running on Empty Food Review.
Well, why is it in like 4-3?
I don't know.
Invite, how do we, what? Just this?
Yeah, I guess so.
Hello, ladies, gentlemen, and everyone watching.
Do we want arcade?
Yeah, probably.
Welcome one and all to this newest edition of the Running on Empty Food Review series. I'm your host,
Theo.
Ted Danson.
Hello, everyone. This is Running on Empty Food Review. Well, hello, ladies, gentlemen, and everyone watching. Well,
I don't think we played this at all.
Welcome one and all to this newest edition of the Running on Empty Food Review series. I'm your host, the Report of the Week. Thanks for checking in. So I'm outside today, changing things up a little bit. It is a warm day, admittedly, late afternoon hours, at least at the time I'm at the camera here, and I'd say the temperature is around 90, but I have braved the elements. There are some thunderstorms in the area, so that's probably going to cool things off anyway, and I thought, what the heck, it's been so long since I've done an outdoor review, let's just go for it, why not? It's always fun doing these, I like the fresh air, you never know what you'll see.
What the hell, I would have got killed by a bubble!
Around you, so hope it's enjoyable, and I hope the lighting and all that works out.
Well, what, do you get a new character or something?
I doubt it.
What am I doing? I'm not even paying attention.
I'm saying brain died.
How do you get in this thing?
Hello, everyone. This is Running on Empty Food Review. Well, hello, ladies, gentlemen, and everyone watching. Welcome one and all to this newest edition of the Running on Empty Food Review series. I'm your host, the Report of the Week. Always a pleasure to be here.
Oh,
giant mosquito.
Wasp!
There haven't been a ton of releases lately, but this is an item that's been, I'd call it fairly new. It's been out for a few weeks, and it was from Burger King, and it caught my interest, and I thought, let's try it out, why not? About a year ago, Burger King, and you might remember these, you might not, for a time last year, Burger King released what they called Whopper Melts. And what those were a couple beef patties, and they were—
Jesus! Come here. Oh, chicken, I got a chicken! What the hell?
It's freaking falling and dying.
Oh. I didn't think we were supposed to actually be on this thing. We're actually fighting people now. No! What?
I think the ship sinks, isn't it?
Does it? Oh, yeah. Oh, shit. No, I don't want to throw it. Throw it the other way! Was that a fart?
No,
toot?
It was the fridge.
Was that like a toot? Toot? Whoa! No! Get out! Fuck. You can't get out of the water once you fall into it.
Yeah.
I don't know what. Continue. I gotta do something.
Oh, no, great. There's the wires or something?
There is, no, not on arcade, we shouldn't.
I don't know.
We're sandwiched between...
Or on free mode, or whatever it is. I remember picking that. Oh my god, the frames! What the hell? What
fat
the hell?
I just walk in the water.
I'm just in the water! That's fun!
Yeah, I'm saying. I couldn't remember who the hell am I? Am I the fat
guy? The blonde one.
Ugh. Because fat guys in the screen.
Oh, fat! Yep, fat guy. Carl.
Jesus Christ.
Essentially toast, and they had American cheese and some sauce, etc. And they were generally well received. I think I tried them, and I thought they were totally fine. I didn't have any problems with them. So Burger King.
Oh shit! Don't fall in the fucking.
Has brought back the Whopper Melts, so now I think they just call them...
Oh, what the hell? There was something back there!
Melts. They got rid of...
Nope. Got farted. Got farted on instead. That'd be nice if I could
Jesus.
Whopper. And they've also added a few specialty melts as well. And one of them, again, caught my interest, so I thought, why not? There's nothing really else to try.
Oh, what's this?
Peas.
Pea shooter wear.
Going the wrong way.
Well, maybe you could turn around, grenade lover. Okay. No. Fell in the.
Alright, so let's see how this is.
I don't know how you could even do this with lives. You'd just be getting fucking falling into the water every two seconds.
This is
getting blown up by mecha.
Sure, random bombs.
It's called the spicy melt, aka they call it the spicy one. And what it has?
You're falling into the water.
Two beef patties.
Wow, I literally spawn in, throw a bomb, and then fall into the water.
I got eaten by the whale, or what?
I fell in the fucking water. Jesus.
I'm getting eaten.
Now, they say these are Whopper Jr.
I literally spawn in, throw them, go to the farthest side, and just throw as many, and then just get thrown them
again.
Throw them, full in the water, blown up by random bombs.
I'm not used to the. Well, I know it's always B to jump, God. I'm never used to it.
Patties. So in total, the two beef patties would equal around 1/4 pound of beef. It has jalapenos, caramelized onions, American cheese, a creamy, spicy sauce. And it is on a toasted bun. So you have the spicy sauce, I suppose, of indeterminate origin, as well as the jalapenos. And that's supposed to give it a bit of a spicy kick, hence the name. Now the price for this is about, it fluctuates anywhere between $5 and $7. So again, I thought it sounds interesting. I could go for the spicy items. So I thought, why not? May as well get it.
Slow, fucking, shitty. Oh.
See how it is, and take it from there. This will be available for a limited time. Again, it's been out for a few weeks. It'll
do it as puked blood or something. No, don't do it again. I was puking blood. Nice blood puke.
What we're supposed to shoot at there?
I don't know.
Probably stay on the menu for another week or two, so if it turns out to be good, get it while the getting's good, I would say. In my case, it was on the pricier end. It was around $7 for me, but many others have said it's around $5.
What are you doing? Puking
guts and blood? Wait, how do you get down there? Go down. How do you fucking... I gotta do the shimmy or something.
Can't even do that.
You gotta like crouch and walk or something. What the hell's that crappy guy doing here? Oh, whoa. No. What is that cloud? What the heck?
What is that?
Does it help us or something? Oh, I guess. Just shock something.
And here it is. Right there, you could. Zooming.
Happen? Just turn into zombie. It takes so long to turn into a zombie.
Slugfest.
The fucking other game didn't do it when you had this. What the hell? What? Monkey to help us?
What the hell happened?
In, you can see the jalapeno.
We had a monkey helping us for like half a second.
The American cheese slices, as well as the
Zombola.
Bread. Top is the spicy sauce. Again, more jalapenos. It's pretty much as advertised, I would say. I think the onion is mixed in there. Let's take a look. Let's debun it and then see for ourselves. Ah, yes, there it is. You see right up there? There's those onions mixed with the jalapenos. And there's a lot of that spicy sauce. And there's the patties. And again,
this counts as a bomb, all it does, too.
And you can see it's kind of crispy around the edges, but it's pretty soft on the, in the center there. But that's a good look of it. You could see, in terms of its size, it's not gigantic or anything, but, you know, it's still about the size.
Shut up! Oh, I could turn into a human again. And then I got turned into a zombie immediately again.
I thought it was you for a second.
Size of a, standard burger, maybe a double. From Burger King. So again, there's the look, there's what it looks like. Available price $5 to $7. What I'm gonna
This fucking zombie puke thing is way better against those helicopters though. Like exploding, taking 12 hours.
Do real quick is I'm actually gonna pause the camera for a second. Well, for you it'll be a second. I'm going to cut it in half, and we'll get a good cross-section, and then I'll take it from there. So I'll be right back in a moment. And indeed, in my case, it was just a moment. And you can see there's a cross-section of it, freshly cut, and there's a good look of everything. So I could smell very potent.
Jesus Christ, yawn. Who cares?
Who gives a shit about
who gives a what happened? I didn't even get hit
oh
by
my God,
it takes so long.
Potently, very sharply, both the onion.
Yeah, zomboli.
As well as the jalapeno. So we'll see how this winds up being. I'll try it out right now. The Burger King spicy melt from Burger King, of course, going in. Hello, everyone. This is Running On Empty Food Review. Well, hello, ladies, gentlemen, and everyone.
Oh, I didn't have taken those. Shit. It gives you your human thing back. There you go.
When watching, welcome one and all to this newest edition of the Running On Empty Food Review Series. I'm your host, the report of the week.
Nice fuck, I didn't even get hit by-
Thanks for checking in. Burger King has done it again. What did they do again? It. Again, that's a-
Jesus Christ. It takes so fucking long. What is happening?
They did. Spicy chicken fries. Every now and then, and I remember when they first started doing this, I would say it was even, gosh, probably back in 2015, 2016, they would always make these various tweaks and adjustments to their chicken fries. And they had all sorts of different types and varieties of chicken fries that they would add to their menu, and that is a trend that still continues to this day, albeit less frequently.
Whoa! Blah!
That's the thing from Star Wars where...
They have had spicy chicken fries in the past, but they've had different names. They've had buffalo chicken fries.
Can I be a zombie again so I can use that blood puke thing, please?
I believe they've had jalapeno.
I don't have any fucking grenades left for some reason.
No chicken fries. But now we've just got spicy chicken fries. And I would presume the description of this really isn't all that detailed. You have their chicken fries, which are essentially little, tiny little slivers of chicken.
What is even fucking happening? Just this gang of balls and shitty aliens.
Ganglion.
I don't even know which one we're supposed to be what the fuck is happening? I just got blown up by balls.
Kind of like
glowing balls. Is that you? What's going on? Nice crap.
Fries. They're breaded, they're fried, and in this case, they're supposed to have a spicy seasoning in the breading. Now, you'll see what they look like in a moment, and then you'll really be able to get a good look at them. But the whole appeal is that these are supposed to be their chicken fries, which I would say are a pretty popular side item of theirs. But
shut up, saying the same thing over and over and over again. 1,000 points, what?
But spicy. And that's really the appeal. That they're just the chicken fries and they're spicy. Price for this. You can get them in a 9-piece order for the price of $8. So $8 for a 9 piece of the spicy chicken fries. With each order of chicken fries, you could also get a side sauce. There's really no go-to sauce, so I decided I'm gonna live on the edge this time around. You could see I really broke out my extra bold red tie, and I did that for a reason, because
I'm gonna avoid these fucking...
I'm going all out in terms of the heat and the spice.
It's vinegar.
We've got this fiery packaging, and I said, let's dial it up. So... I got their
complete crap video here.
Buffalo
sauce. Yup, pops up.
Sauce. Because I'm all about just pushing the envelope. So we're entering dangerous territory here. We may be witnessing a spice overload. We will see. As you can see, the packaging. Spicy. We've got the fermented.
How far are grenades gonna work here? like hockey pucks.
What the fuck?
How's this guy not died? He's all blue. Wait, I forgot. I thought it was you for a second. I got killed.
Hello.
So confusing.
Hello, everyone. This is Running On Empty Food Review. Well, hello, ladies, gentlemen, and everyone watching. Welcome, one and all, to this newest edition of the Running On Empty Food Review Series. I'm your host, the Report of the Week. Thanks for checking in. Taco Bell is doing what they do best. And what does Taco Bell do best? They release new items. Good or bad, they are always extremely consistent when it comes down to these new releases. And Taco Bell, well, they continue doing just that. Today's review is for a new burrito released from Taco Bell. You will never...
Tanks being thrown down?
Guess. You'll never guess what is on this burrito. It's not like it's in the name or anything. It's gonna blow your mind, are you ready? What if I told you?
Oh, Jesus. I can't... I keep thinking I'm you half the time.
That Taco Bell has these magical things that are these often three-dimensional.
Like half
rockies.
Get fucking, I keep thinking I'm you, Jesus.
Rectangular strips composed.
Hillary Swank.
Jesus fucking Christ.
Jesus Christ.
No.
Of potato meat. They are fried and they took these objects and wrapped them in a tortilla with other ingredients. I can't even begin to imagine such a concept.
Nice video! Fucking
nothing
rock
cam. Tom's gonna start with spamming A button.
Taco Bell did just that though, because we know that when it comes down to innovation, when it comes down to creativity, Taco Bell is unparalleled. There's nothing that even comes close to them. Yeah, that's sarcastic, because I'll be honest. Taco Bell has the nacho fries. I have no objection to the nacho fries from Taco Bell at all. I enjoy them. I like them. Every time I have tried out the nacho fries, I've given them a good review. Taco Bell has obviously incorporated the nacho fries into many an item. They have them on their own. They have nacho fries burritos. They have nacho fries bowls. And there are all sorts of various things that you could have the nacho fries added to. You could still like them as a product, but you could also feel this way where you could say, you know, I like them, but at this point in time, the nacho fries, generally, and I see this, I see what people have to say about them, are a stale, overdone concept that generates little to no interest. You could feel both.
Can't even, like, fucking do damage to half of these stupid, shitty cameras.
Of those ways, and I do. And that's what I see. A lot of people say, yeah, the nacho fries are good and all, but they're kind of overdone. I mean, come on, Taco Bell, they could, you know, is that it? Are you just gonna add nacho fries to this or to that? Is there anything else you could do? And I see that sentiment quite a bit. And I'm curious, before I get into this review, if you are a Taco Bell regular, if you have any thoughts about them, what do you think about the nacho fries at Taco Bell?
Shield dummies, what the hell, I got a laser
the shield.
Jesus, what happened? I'm gonna kill with nothing.
Taco Bell, do you think that it's an overdone gimmick at this point as well? Or do you think that, you know, it doesn't really matter, just incorporate them as much?
And Seth Ambrose, whatever his
name is. Seth Ambrose, classic. Ow.
Dean Ambrose, oops.
So what do you think? If you want to leave a comment, I'm curious what you thought, but I just get the impression that it's kind of overdone. A lot of people are kind of, it's like, eh, come on, just leave them on the menu. You know, it's not that big of an exciting deal anymore like they were in 2018. But nonetheless, now let's actually get it.
Wow, just pick something up and get fucked by ass. What?
Into this. Taco Bell is still going all out with the nacho fries. They are back. And they've also released a special burrito with nacho fries therein. And in this instance, they have released the Chili Verde Fries Burrito. Now, you could get it with just the nacho fries, or you could get it with steak added. I got the steak variety. So here's what it has in it. Steak, obviously filet mignon. Their nacho fries. Nacho cheese sauce. A three cheese blend. Chile verde sauce. Sour cream. And fiesta strips. And it's all wrapped together in a tortilla. And it is available for the price of $5. The steak, chile verde,
what am I doing?
Fries burrito from Taco Bell. I got the burrito by itself, got it right here. This is interesting, actually. I don't know if this was necessarily intentional, but I will say it's actually kind of a bit of a relief, because this kind of proves that at least I got the right item, so that's good. You see right there? See the green? You might say, what is that? Right? What is that green stuff?
What the hell? No. Give me that shit. There.
Is that algae?
What the hell? I got a different gun for this thing?
What is that? Is that trees? Money?
I think he's a boss or something.
Great!
That, I believe.
Oh, yeah, I called it.
Is the chile verde.
Turn! Fucking turn!
De sauce. The namesake of this burrito. Yeah, I know it could be kind of silly, but here's what it looks like, though. It's like a standard burrito, but it actually, again, I don't think that was intentional, but it's just nice to actually see the sauce on the outside, because I'll give a little bit of an example. You know, the lighting is kind of bleached out right there. There's a better look at it. And there's the other end. Has its structural integrity. But, around New
Year's... Oh, he's got a big wiener sticking out! Oh, it's explosive! I think the floor just blow... That's fun. More floor-breaking shit.
Here. They released a burrito.
Oh, great! Brainless! Oh, wiener missiles again.
Called the...
Fuck, is this a dodge zone?
No, fuck. Oh, don't fall into the fucking... Throw something. I don't have anything left.
Salsa Verde burrito. And I tried it out, and it was such a disappointment.
Anal fire.
Yeah, spawn is some ugly guy. No.
Because...
I don't know, there's no way to fucking dodge that.
Yeah.
Doesn't seem like there is anyway.
There's no sauce in there, but there was very little.
Anal missile.
It swipes literally the whole fucking screen.
Pretty much.
So actually seeing the sauce on the outside verifiably is a good sign. What I'm going to do right now, because I think I was able to describe it sufficiently, you know what's on it.
No, don't be that ugly guy, I don't care about him. Oh no, hell no.
Hell no, to the no, yeah, to the no.
Alright, that was Metal Slug.